the server from my Minecraft clone, slowly became to be one of the most complex multi-threaded systems that I had to design. It can run theoretically on an unlimited number of threads, yet it is still simple. To achieve this, however, I had to refactor it several times, and I still have to refactor it some more, but it's totally worth it. So let's start from the beginning. I think that approach-based design is the best way of writing software. This means starting with something that seems right and changing it with something better as you learn more about the program that you are trying to implement. So, at the center of any Minecraft server, there is the chunk system. This is what holds the world, and I implemented it differently from the chunk system for the players, because they use chunks differently. So, I came up with the idea to store chunks in a recently used cache. This is just a big pool of chunks, and it has a limited capacity. Whenever I want to load a new chunk, the last chunk that was used will be removed to make space. This helps because usually players stay together, so the server would need to send the same chunk to multiple people. And I also placed this system in a different thread from the main one. So the server has two threads, the main one and the worker thread that has the chunk system and also generates the world. This is good because world generation takes a lot of time, so I don't want to keep the server busy with too many chunk generation requests. But once I had identities, this system started to not look so good anymore. For one, in a good multi-threaded system, you don't want multiple threads to work over the same resource, like in this case, the world. Yes, you can use mutexes, but they are slow, so it's better if the worker thread does all of the world-related update and the main thread does the rest. But in practice, since everything revolves around the world, the worker thread ended up doing all of the work, and the main thread only receiving networking updates. And they still had to use mutexes, because they both shared the information about the player, and I had to log mutexes for quite long to make sure players don't get disconnected while I use them. So I changed the system, but first, if you like this series, you'll be able to vote again on YouTube what the next video should be on. So make sure you subscribe to not miss that poll when it comes out. So I decided to merge these two threads together. Don't worry, we'll add more threads later. And I also replaced the chunk system with a simple unorder map, and I just kept the chunks around the players always loaded. The problem was that once I added entities, I need to have the concept of a loaded and unloaded chunk, so that I don't simulate entities for unloaded chunks. Plus, the chunks around the player need to be always loaded, or else entities won't be simulated properly there. And the logic for all of this became messy, so I just replaced the entire system with something more simple, and it works even better. I was afraid of having to load chunks from the disk too often, but this system avoids this way better. Plus, apparently, it doesn't even take long to load chunks from the disk. So maybe parameter optimizations are indeed bad sometimes. Side rant, but this is why I never liked the fact that we only do algorithms in school, and a lot of them in university. This recently used cache was literally the most complex data structure that I had to design in my almost 10 years of game dev. I'm not even kidding. And I have my own engine, and games made from scratch, and an emulator, and a programming language. This was the most complex, and it is just a map and a list. And I haven't even learned about it in university. And now, I'm not even using it anymore. Anyway, now it's time to add back multi-threading, and I have found an interesting idea on the web that would theoretically allow me to use an infinite number of threads. But to do that, I need to store entities in a specific way, and that is each chunk stores its own entities. This is actually quite nice, because each chunk can easily save its own entities now. And this also means that I can easily find on the server which entities are in a given area by looking at the entities in the chunks close to that region. It has a downside, and it is the fact that I need to check all the entities if they moved in a new chunk, and move them there. And I thought it would give me performance problems when I get to a few thousand entities. But Minecraft can also struggle with big numbers like that, so I'm probably okay for now. Also, on the client, I just store all entities normally in a single array per entity, because I use entities totally different there. Now, why do I do all of this? Well, take a look here. These are the chunks that need to be updated. The thing is that they don't touch each other, and an entity here can at most teleport during a frame to another region, but not interact with it. So this means that each region can be simulated on another thread, without any need of mutexes. So each frame, I run a simple breadth-first search algorithm on the main chunk storage to determine what are the regions, and then move the chunks in a new chunk storage for each region. Don't worry, I just copy pointers around, so it is not expensive, and this chunk will come with its own entities. So this system is actually just a matter of splitting the chunks into regions, and in the end, putting them back together. And finally, I have a thread pool waiting for work, that will keep the right number of threads open to accommodate the current chunk region's demand. Now, this is very important, because in the future, I want my game to encourage exploration. So I want the server to be efficient, even if players load many chunks by not staying together. But I have a lot more to do. I kinda need to move the world generation to a new thread, and maybe also create a separate thread to handle networking updates. But I'll see when I get there. So don't forget to subscribe to not miss on voting what the next video should be on, and maybe check the last video that was on entities. See you there!